Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 25 and we are going to solve problem in the normal shock. Problem in the normal shock part 2. So we recap from the earlier lecture. So we discussed the flow with normal shock in a constant area duct and in the convergent divergent nozzle and the variable area duct. We have calculated the change in property across the normal shock wave and we discussed the problem in the earlier lecture, and in this lecture also we continue with the problem solving in flow with the normal shock. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the students will be able to solve problem in the flow with the normal shock. This is the gas table which we will be referring for problem solving in flow with the normal shock for three different fluid with gamma equal to 1.3, gamma equal to 1.4 and gamma equal to 1.67. We refer table number 4.1, 4.2 and 4.3. And the majority of the problem with the gamma equal to 1.4. And rarely the property gamma will be given in the problem. If the fluid is mentioned as air, we have to necessarily take gamma equal to 1.4. Example number 6, the total temperature and total pressure of air in a reservoir supplying a converging diverging nozzle are 450 Kelvin and 4 bar respectively. The nozzle throat area, throat is 6 cm square and nozzle exit area is 18 cm square. A shock wave noted at a position in the divergent portion where the area is 12 cm square. So, what are the exit pressure, temperature and velocity? Subdivision 2, what value of the back pressure would just cause the flow through the nozzle is completely supersonic. What value of the back pressure would result completely isentropic flow interior and exterior to the nozzle? And this is from November 2012 question paper. And this is the converging diverging nozzle with one is the inlet condition, T stands for throat section and two is the outlet of the nozzle and X and Y. So here we have the normal shock. Before the shock the properties are taken as X and after the shock the properties are taken as Y. So we are given PO1 equal to 4 bar, PO1 equal to 450 Kelvin and we are given throat area 6 cm square, exit area 18 cm square. And the area where the nozzle and where the shock occurs, AX equal to AY equal to 12 cm square. And we know PO1 equal to POX, PO1 equal to POX equal to 4 bar, POY equal to PO2, TO1 equal to TOY, stagnation temperature throughout the nozzle with the normal shock it is constant, TO1 equal to TOX equal to TOY equal to TO2 equal to 450 Kelvin and the throat area AT is also equal to A1 star, AX star and AT star. So, A1 star is the star stands for the Mach number equal to 1 and similarly on the after the shock AY star equal to A2 star. Area ratio at normal shock. So, area ratio where the normal shock occurs AX by AX star. So, AX by AX star equal to AX star equal to refer to the table AX star equal to AT. So, AX by AX star equal to 12 by 6 equal to 2. Now from isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 35, gamma equal to 1.4 and AX by AX star equal to 2, MX equal to 2.2. So the Mach number where the shock occurs, normal shock occurs in the divergent part is 2.2. Now from the normal shock table, table number 4.2, page number 53, at MX equal to 2.2 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take MY equal to 0.547, POY by POX equal to 0.628. Now the stagnation pressure after the shock PO2 equal to POY equal to 0.628 into POX which is 0.628 into 400 equal to 251.2 kilopascal. Now from the isentropic table, table number 3.2 page number 29 at MY equal to 0.547 and gamma equal to 1.4 we take AY by AY star equal to 1.2595. The area ratio at the exit A2 by A2 star equal to A2 by AY into AY by A2 star because A2 star equal to AY star. So, this equal to 18 by 12. So, A2 by AY equal to A2 equal to 18 centimeter square, AY equal to 12 centimeter square and AY by A2 star, AY by A2 star equal to 1.2595 which is equal to 1.89. Now the isentropic table, refer the isentropic table 3.2, page number 29, at A2 by A2 star equal to 1.89 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take M2 equal to 0.326, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.9288, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.9784. Now the pressure properties at the exit, pressure and temperature at the exit, P2 equal to 0.9288 into PO2 equal to 0.9288 into 251.2 equal to 233 kilopascal, T2 equal to 0.9784 into TO2 equal to 0.9784 into 450 equal to 440.28 Kelvin. And velocity C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 0.326 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 440.28 equal to 137.1 meters per second. What value of the back pressure would just cause the flow through the nozzle completely supersonic? So when you want, there is no shock wave. Now there is no shock wave at the outlet of the nozzle, the flow is supersonic. So the nozzle is working on isentropic condition. So the, for completely supersonic flow in the nozzle, so A2 by A2 star equal to 18 by 6 equal to 3. Now for isentropic table, table number 3.2, page number 36, at A2 by A star equal to 3, gamma equal to 1.4, we take M2 equal to 2.64, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.0471, and T2 by T1 equal to 0.417. Now the pressure properties at the exit, pressure and temperature at the exit, P2 equal to 0.0471 into PO2 equal to 0.0471 into 400 equal to 18.84 kilopascal, T2 equal to 0.417 into TO2 equal to 0.417 into 450 equal to 187.65 Kelvin. And the answer to the problem, for shock wave, flow with the shock wave, the exit pressure where the velocity with the shock wave, exit pressure, temperature and velocity with the shock wave, P2 equal to 2.33 bar, T2 equal to 440.28, C2 equal to 137.1 meters per second. Value of the back pressure would just cause the flow through the nozzle completely supersonic, P2 equal to 18.84 kilopascal. Value of the back pressure would result completely isentropic flow. Again, isentropic flow or supersonic flow, both are equal, so P2 equal to 18.84 kilopascal. Example number 7, a nozzle is designed assuming reversible adiabatic flow with an exit Mach number of 2.6, while air having a stagnation pressure and temperature of 2 MPa and 150 degree Celsius respectively. The mass flow rate is 5 kg per second and gamma equal to 1.4. Determine exit pressure, temperature and area, exit area and throat area. Subdivision 2, suppose that the back pressure at the nozzle exit is raised to 1.35 MPa. And that the flow remains isentropic except for normal shock wave. Determine the exit Mach number and temperature and mass flow rate through the nozzle. So this is from May 2013 question paper. So this is the converging diverging nozzle which is given, and here we are given M2 equal to 2.6. Outlet condition with the shock wave, outlet condition is 2.6, PO2 equal to 2000 kilopascal, which is 2 megapascal equal to 2000 kilopascal, TO2 equal to 150 degree Celsius, which is 423 Kelvin, mass flow rate equal to 5 kilograms per second, gamma equal to 1.4. And we know PO1 equal to POX, POY equal to PO2 equal to 2000 kilopascal, stagnation temperatures are constant, TO1 equal to TOY equal to TOX equal to TOY equal to TO2 equal to 423 Kelvin, A1 star equal to AX star equal to AT star equal to AT, throat area, AY star equal to A2 star. Now isentropic table, M2 equal to 2.6, gamma equal to 1.4, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.0501, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.425, A2 by ASR equal to 2.896. So the properties at the exit, P2 equal to 0.0501 into PO2 equal to 0.0501 into 2000 equal to 100.2 kilopascal, T2 equal to 0.425 into TO2, which is 0.425 into 423 equal to 180.2 Kelvin. And velocity, density rho2 equal to P2 by RT2, 100.2 divided by 0.287 into 180.2 equal to 1.94 kilogram per meter cube. Velocity C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, so 2.6 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 180.2 equal to 699.61 meters per second. Area A2 equal to M by rho2 C2. So from the continuity equation, area at the exit section 5 divided by 1.94 into 699.61 equal to 3.6 10 power minus 3 meter square. So from the expression here, A2 by A star 2.896, we calculate throat area, AT equal to A2 by 2.896, which is 3.6 in 10 power minus 3 divided by 2.896 equal to 1.271 10 power minus 3 meter square. When the back pressure is changed in P2, when the change is 2, P2 equal to 1.35 megapascal, which is 1350 kilopascal. So P2 by PO2 equal to 1350 divided by 2000 equal to 0.675. Now from the isentropic table again, for this pressure ratio P2 by PO2 equal to 0.675 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take M2 equal to 0.771, A2 by A star equal to 1.0513, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.8937. Now the properties at the exit, T2 equal to 0.8937 into TO2 equal to 0.8937 into 423 equal to 378 Kelvin, and the rho2 density equal to P2 by R into T2, which is 1350 divided by 0.287 into 378 equal to 12.44 kilogram per meter cube. Velocity C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2, which is 0.771 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 378, which is 300.47 meters per second, and mass flow rate now rho2 A2 C2 12.44 into 3.6 in 10 power minus 3 into 300.47 equal to 13.71 kilograms per second. The answer to the problem, for the first part, the exit properties are P2 equal to 100.2 kilopascal, T2 equal to 180.2 Kelvin, and A2 equal to 36.8 centimeter square. When the back pressure is changed to 1350 kilopascal, Mach number equal to 0.771, temperature equal to 378 Kelvin, and the mass flow rate equal to 13.71 kilograms per second. Example number 8, the ratio of the exit to the entry area of a subsonic diffuser is 4. The Mach number of a jet of air approaching the diffuser, PO equal to 1.013 bar and temperature T equal to 290 Kelvin is 2.2, Mach number is 2.2. There is a standing normal shock wave just outside the diffuser entry. The flow in the diffuser is isentropic. Determine at the exit of the diffuser, Mach number, temperature, pressure, stagnation pressure loss between initial and final states of the flow. This is from May 2010 and May 2013 question paper. So this is the diffuser. So the shock wave is standing at the entrance, just at the entrance of the diffuser. So here outlet of the diffuser is designated as 2. Before the shock wave, the properties are X. After the shock wave, at the entry of the diffuser, the properties are Y. So we are given PO1 equal to 1.013 bar. So the pressure, the Mach number is just air approaching the diffuser. PO1 equal to 1.013 bar, T1 equal to 290 Kelvin, and the MX equal to 2.2, A2 by AY equal to 4. A2 is the exit area, AY is the entry area of the diffuser, which is 4. From isentropic table 3.2, page number 35, Mach number MX equal to 2.2 and gamma equal to 1.4. If we take PX by POX equal to 0.0935, TX by TOX equal to 0.508. Now the stagnation temperature at the entry, TOX equal to TX divided by 0.508, 290 divided by 0.508 equal to 570.87 Kelvin, and PX static pressure PX equal to 0.0935 into POX, which is 0.0935 into 1.013 equal to 0.0947 bar. Now from normal shock table, table number 4.2, page number 53, at MX equal to 2.2 and gamma equal to 1.4, MY equal to 0.547, POY by PX equal to 5.48, POY by POX equal to 0.628, TY by TX equal to 1.857. Now we take the properties after the shock, POY equal to 5.48 into PX, which is 5.48 into 0.0947 equal to 0.52 bar. TY equal to 1.857 into TX, which is 1.857 into 290 equal to 538.53 Kelvin. PO2 equal to POY equal to 0.628 into POX, which is 0.628 into 1.013 equal to 0.636 bar. Again from the isentropic table, 3.2, page number 29, at MY equal to 0.547 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take AY by AY star equal to 1.26. A2 by A star, the area ratio for the exit of the diffuser, A2 by A star equal to A2 by AY into AY by AY star, which is 4 into 1.26 equal to 5.04. Now referring to the isentropic table again, For the area ratio, A2 by SR equal to 5.04, gamma equal to 1.4, M2 equal to 0.116, P2 by PO2 equal to 0.9902, T2 by TO2 equal to 0.997. Now, the properties at the exit, P2 equal to 0.9902 into PO2, which is 0.9902 into 0.636 equal to 0.63 bar, and T2 equal to 0.997 into TO2, which is 0.997 into 570.87 equal to 569.15 Kelvin. The stagnation pressure loss, delta PO equal to POX minus POY, which is 1.013 minus 0.636 equal to 0.377 bar. So, the answer to the problem, Mach number at the exit 0.116, temperature at the exit 569.15 Kelvin, pressure at the exit 0.63 bar, and the stagnation pressure loss equal to 0.377 bar. Example number 9, the stagnation pressure and temperature of air at the entry of a nozzle is 5 bar and 450 Kelvin respectively. The exit Mach number is 2.1 where the normal shock occurs. Calculate the following quantity before and after the shock. Static temperature, stagnation temperature, static pressure, stagnation pressure loss and the increase in entropy. This is from May 2014 question paper. So, given data, PO1 equal to POX, PO1 equal to POX equal to 5 bar, TO1 equal to TOX equal to TOY equal to 450 Kelvin and MX equal to 2.1. Exit of the nozzle, that is before the shock wave, the Mach number equal to 2.1. From isentropic table 3.2, page number 34, MX equal to 2.1 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take PX by POX equal to 0.109, TX by TOX equal to 0.531. So, the properties before the shock, PX equal to 0.109 into POX, which is 0.109 into 5 equal to 0.545 bar, TX equal to 0.531 into TOX, which is 0.531 into 450 equal to 238.95 Kelvin. From normal shock table, page number 53, MX equal to 2.1, gamma equal to 1.4, MY equal to 0.561, PY by PX equal to 4.978, POY by POX equal to 0.674, TY by TX equal to 1.77. Now, we calculate the properties after the shock. PY equal to 4.978 into PX, which is 4.978 into 0.544 equal to 2.71 bar. TY equal to 1.77 into TX, which is 1.77 into 238.95 equal to 422.94 Kelvin. POY equal to 0.674 into POX, which is 0.674 into 5 equal to 3.37 bar. So, the stagnation pressure loss delta PO equal to POX minus POY, which is 5 minus 3.37 equal to 1.63 bar. Change in entropy, delta S equal to R into logarithmic of POX by POY, which is 287 into logarithmic of 5 divided by 3.37 equal to 113.23 joules per kilogram Kelvin. So, the answer to the problem, properties before and after the shock. Static temperature, TX equal to 238.95 Kelvin, TY equal to 422.94 Kelvin. Stagnation temperature, TOX equal to TOY equal to 450 Kelvin. Static pressure, PX equal to 0.545 bar, PY equal to 2.71 bar. Stagnation pressure, POX equal to 5 bar, POY equal to 3.37 bar. Stagnation pressure loss, 1.63 bar. Increase in entropy, 113.23 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Example number 10, air pressure of 685 millibar and temperature 310 Kelvin enters 60 centimeter diameter duct at a Mach number 3. The flow passes through the normal shock wave at a section L1 meter downstream of the entry where the Mach number is 2.5. The Mach number at the exit at the location L2 meter downstream of the shock is 0.8. The mean coefficient of friction is 0.005. Determine length L1 and L2, state of air at the exit and mass flow through the duct. This is from November 2014 question paper. So, here we have a flow through constant area duct with the friction, that is fan of flow. So, now the shock occurs in the fan of flow. So, the flow enters the duct in the supersonic condition at the somewhere downwards where MX equal to 2.5, there is a shock wave occurs and then the flow becomes subsonic. So, this is the fan of flow with a shock, normal shock. So the length L1 is the length between entry and the shock wave, and L2 is the length between shock wave to the exit of the duct. So we are given P1 equal to 0.685 bar. So 685 millibar, which is 0.685 bar. T1 equal to 310 Kelvin. Diameter equal to 0.6 meter. M1 equal to 3. MX equal to 2.5. And M2 equal to 0.8. Now from fan of flow table 6.2 page number 85 at gamma equal to 1.4. We take the properties at the M1 equal to 1, M1 equal to 3, and the MX equal to 2.5. We take the property P by P star, T by T star, 4 FL max by D. So the values are 0.218, 0.428, 0.522, 0.292, 0.533, 0.432. Now, we calculate the properties before the shock. So PX equal to P1 into PX by P star divided by P1 by P star, which is 0.685 into 0.292 divided by 0.218 equal to 0.917 bar. TX equal to T1 into TX by T star divided by T1 by T star equal to 310 into 0.533 divided by 0.428 equal to 386.05 Kelvin. And we have 4FL1 divided by D equal to 4 FL max by D at Mach number M1. Minus 4 FL max by D at Mach number MX. Substituting 4 into 0.001 into L1 divided by 0.6 equal to 0.522 minus 0.432. So solving this equation, the length L1 equal to 2.7 meter. Now we calculate the density rho x equal to Px by R into Tx, which is 91.7 divided by 0.287 into 386.05 equal to 0.828 kilogram per meter cube. Cx velocity equal to mx into square root of gamma rtx, which is 2.5 into square root of 1.4 into 287 into 386.05 equal to 984.6 meters per second. So the mass flow rate equal to rho x, ax and cx. So which is 0.828, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.6 square, this is the area, into 984.6 equal to 230.4 kilograms per second. Now from the normal shock table 4.2 page number 54 at MX equal to 2.5 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take MY equal to 0.513, PY by PX equal to 7.125, TY by TX equal to 2.138. So the properties after the shock, PY equal to 7.125 into PX, which is 7.125 into 0.917 equal to 6.53 bar, TY equal to 2.138 into TX, which is 2.138 into 386.05 equal to 825.4 Kelvin. Again from the fan of flow table, table number 6.2, page number 85 and gamma equal to 1.4, we take properties at MY equal to 0.513 and M2 equal to 0.8. So P by P star 2.082, T by T star 1.14, 4 FL max by T equal to 0.9702. Here for M2 equal to 0.8, 1.289, 1.064 and 0.073. Now the properties after the shock. So P2 equal to PY into P2 by P star divided by PY by P star, which is 6.53 into 1.289 divided by 2.082 equal to 4.043 bar, and T2 equal to TY into T2 by T star divided by TY by T star, which is 825.4 into 1.064 divided by 1.148 equal to 770.4 Kelvin, and the 4 FL2 by D, which is equal to 4 FL max by D at MY minus 4 FL max by D at M2. Substituting values 4 into 0.005 into L2 divided by 0.6 equal to 0.9702 minus 0.073. So solving this equation, L2 equal to 26.72 meter. The answer to the problem, L1 equal to 2.7 meter, L2 equal to 26.72 meter, properties at the exit, P2 equal to 4.043 bar, T2 equal to 770.4 Kelvin, and the mass flow rate equal to 230.4 kilograms per second. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering. You may find the gas dynamics and jet propulsion. You please refer to the book for additional problem in the flow with normal shock. And I upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. You can refer to the use the channel for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again with another video lecture in the gas dynamics and jet propulsion. Until then, bye bye.